All right, today we're going to learn how to make refrigerator pickles. Very simple to make, cheaper depending on your ingredients and what you would buy in the store. And they take a lot quicker to make than you would expect. Really, what you need and what we have here is all the ingredients. Prep time, 10 to 15 minutes, and that's mostly chopping. So here we have two full cucumbers. Took some black pepper, peppercorn, ground up a little bit. We have some coarse sea salt. Chopped up, that's actually just half an onion. Then of course is dill. Here's the dill that we bought. Organic, a little more expensive. That's all I had in the store. Also, for spiciness, some dried peppers. So these are the peppers that we were able to purchase. And then garlic. To make this is very simple. You need cucumbers and brine. Your brine is what you're going to be able to pickle with. The pickling is vinegar. So we have just regular white vinegar. And depending on the size, this is, let's say, one part vinegar to 1 to 2 parts water. And what we will do in a second is make the brine. The brine is vinegar, salt, and water. Boil it for 10 minutes, about that part, and then that's your brine. Everything else goes into the pickling jar. So I'm moving the stove. I put 1 part vinegar and 2 parts water. Next, we're going to mix in the salt. This is a coarse salt. Some people will add sugar also. I don't prefer that. What will happen is after about 12 minutes, once it starts boiling and the salt dissolves, stir it up a little bit, that'll be your brine. That's your pickling solution. So what we're going to do as the brine is cooking and boiling is going to put in the ingredients, and then we're going to pour the brine over it once that's done boiling. So what I'm looking to do is onions, and this is half an onion. Just putting that on the bottom, no reason. And the pepper. All this is going to mix together, so it really doesn't matter what order you put it in. Next, cucumbers. This was 2 cucumbers, cut them a little thick. Actually threw a little bit of extra salt on top of them that will dry them out as we're waiting for the brine to go. Cucumbers, of course, take the longest to put in. And the idea is to fully pack them down firmly as possible. Besides that is gonna be the dill. Still have some cucumbers. I'll mix some dill in at this point. But the brine is going to wash it all down to the bottom. And then it really depends on what type of flavor you want in your pickles. If you want them spicy, throw in hot pepper. If you want them extra spicy, throw in a second hot pepper. I'm a fan of garlic. Lot of garlic that can go into them. Again, as these get packed down, well, it doesn't matter where they go. You can shake up the bottle afterwards and everything will fit in. The important part really is your brine is going to be your pickling agent, and that's based on what flavor that you want. As you can see, this is full. 2 cucumbers. And that will do it. Now we wait for the brine to be finished and we'll pour on the top. Okay, so a slightly uneven bottom of a pot right there. You can see it's actually shaking while it boils. So I'll drop the temperature down. But what you can see is because we're using the kosher sea salt, that's coarse, the salt's actually already dissolving, which makes it a lot quicker. So less than 10 minutes is sufficient for the boiling process. Well, the purpose is to get this all dissolved in there before you pour it in. But with kosher sea salt, that does it a lot easier. All right, the water has boiled, all the brine and everything is ready. So the salt has dissolved into it. Now all it takes is pouring it into the cucumbers, which will become pickles. Measure this out, so this should be about the correct amount. Got a little bit extra because of all the pickles in. Just want to fill it up slightly below the brim there. Add a little bit extra because of the volume of the cucumbers that are in there and everything else. Now all that takes is waiting. Once this has cooled down a little bit, we'll put it in the refrigerator, put the top on, and then wait. Time frame varies. Some people start eating these after 3 days, 10 days, 14 days. I'd go on the earlier time period because these may last maybe a month or so in the refrigerator. After that point, they start getting a little softer. So really, a week or so should be sufficient. As you can see, everything's in there, and in a couple days we'll come back, take a look at it, and see how it looks, and I'll let you know once I can start tasting them.